In this video, we'll talk about proteins and crystals and X-ray crystallography. We'll get just the most general sense of how X-ray crystallography works and how it provides such valuable information to a target-based drug discovery program. Drugs act on proteins. If you want to design a drug, you need it to bind to a target protein. Well, proteins are very large molecules, but they're not amorphous blobs. They actually typically have a fairly well-defined shape. And the shape of the protein will dictate the shape of the drug that will bind to that protein. So the shape of the protein target will tell us the shape of our drug molecule. Well, that raises a question. How do you determine the shape of a protein? There are many methods. The one that we will focus upon is X-ray crystallography. X-ray crystallography is a technique that requires purified protein crystals. Indeed, a limitation of X-ray crystallography is that not all proteins form crystals appropriate for analysis. Regardless, very many drug targets work quite well. The protein sample is placed in the path of an X-ray beam. The X-rays pass through the sample and are scattered by the electrons in the protein. The scattering pattern can be used to determine the three-dimensional structure of the protein. I am skipping many details. This is a complex process, but these are the main ideas. Let's quickly look at a protein structure. This screen is the homepage for a website of the Research Collaboratory for Structural Bioinformatics Protein Data Bank, the RCSB-PDB. Most everyone calls this the PDB. The PDB is a repository of protein structures, mostly X-ray structures. Each protein has a 4-character code. Let's look up a specific protein, lysozyme, with a code of 3LZT. And here is the protein page. In the upper left corner is the structure. Let's click on the structure link below the image. And I'm going to change our view, by scrolling to the bottom, to the NGL viewer. There are multiple ways to visualize proteins. And here we are. Here is our protein. This is called a ribbon or cartoon diagram of the protein. The view highlights the overall shape of the protein just by showing the backbone of the protein chain. If you hover your cursor over parts of the backbone, it will tell you exactly which amino acid is in that part of the backbone. So this type of structural information is extremely valuable for finding molecules that will affect the protein, the target protein. So here's the protein structure. We can now start to make educated guesses on what kind of molecule, drug molecule, might bind to this protein. Fantastic. We've now learned a little bit about proteins, that they have structures, and that there are means, X-ray crystallography, for determining the structure of a protein. And furthermore, there are resources out there, like the Protein Data Bank, that allow us to visualize these structures and begin to gain information from those protein structures.